Hi! Hello mga katropa! Andito na naman po tayo sa ating Criminology Gabay Kaalaman. Again, this is your coach, Coach Ed Montalba po. So at this point in time, ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon, si fingerprint po. Okay, dadalhin ko po kayo sa mundo ng fingerprint at this point in time. But guys, before I will proceed, yung hindi pa po nakapag-subscribe sa channel na to, please do subscribe in my channel. And please do not forget to hit the notification bell so that you will be updated every time na mag-upload po tayo ng mga criminology video dito po sa ating channel. Okay? So ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon, let us try to discuss what are the different rules in the selection of a delta and a core. Okay? So ang bida natin sa ngayon, si delta at saka si core po. Let us try to know first kung ano po si delta at saka ano po si core. Tandaan po natin, pag delta at saka core po, these two are considered as the two focal points in the study of fingerprint. So siya po ang pinaka-basis po, the moment the fingerprint expert, the fingerprint technician will try to count the ridges of a fingerprint. Ang basis po nila, si delta at saka si core po. Kaya po, tinatawag po silang the two focal points of a fingerprint. Okay, so ano po si delta at saka ano po si core? Pag sinasabi po nating core, core is the approximate center of the pattern. Ang core po ay makikita sa pinakasintro po ng fingerprint pattern. Guys, tandaan po natin, si core is sometimes called the inner terminus, while delta is sometimes called the outer terminus. Ano po si delta? Si delta po is that point on a ridge at or in front of and the nearest center of the divergence of the two type lines. Okay? So in other words, si delta ay makikita po natin doon po sa divergence of the two type lines. So ngayon, ano po si type lines? Okay? Si type lines po are two innermost ridges that starts parallel, diverge, surround, or tend to surround the pattern area. Again, type lines are two innermost ridges that starts parallel, diverge, surround, or tend to surround the pattern area. So yung point of divergence of the two type lines po, dyan po natin makikita po si delta. Okay, i-illustrate po natin kung ano po si type lines at saka saan po makikita si delta. Now, in this illustration guys, this is a loop type of pattern. As you notice, ridge A, B, C. 1, 2, 3. Okay? So, ridge is A, B, C. 1, 2, 3. These six ridges are parallel to each other. Okay? So, saan po dyan si type lines? Si type lines po, as defined earlier, are two innermost ridges that starts parallel, diverge, surround, or tend to surround the pattern area. Okay? Kung titingnan po natin to, they are parallel to each other. Okay? These ridges are parallel to each other. But ang pinaka-innermost po na ridges dito ay si ridge C at saka si ridge 1. Diba? Siya po ang pinaka-innermost. Okay? And then kung titingnan po natin, si ridge C at saka si ridge 1 starts parallel at saka nag-diverge po. Diba? Kung natatandaan nyo pa po yung definition po ng divergence, no? The splitting apart of two ridges after running parallel. Okay? So, the splitting apart of two ridges after running parallel. In other words, yung sinabi po natin kanina na yung type lines po are two innermost ridges that starts parallel, diverge. So, kung titingnan po natin yung dalawang ridges na to, nagda-diverge sila. Now, ngayon, di ba, sinabi po natin kanina na yung delta po ay makikita at the point of divergence of the two type lines. In other words po, if this is the point of divergence of the two type lines, therefore, delta can be located in this area. Diyan po makikita si delta. Now, considering that delta is located at the point of divergence of the two type lines, ano ho ba ang forma ni delta? So, ano bang itsura ni delta po? A delta could either be a bifurcation, a delta could either be an abrupt ending, okay, or a ridge end. A delta could either be a dot, a delta can be a short ridge, or it is a meeting of two ridges. Yung tinatawag po nating convergence. Or, that is the point of the first recurving ridge located nearest to the center and in front of the divergence of the two type lines. Okay? So, again, uulitin ko po. Ano po si delta? A delta can either be bifurcation. A delta can either be an abrupt ending or a short, a ridge ending. A delta can either, could either be that. A delta can be a short ridge. A delta can be a meeting of two ridges. Okay? So ngayon, now how if po doon sa point of divergence of the two type lines, there gonna be a lot of possible deltas. Paano po kung doon po sa point of divergence of the two type lines, andun po lahat yung sinasabi natin kanina na pwede po na maging delta. Okay? Take this example. Okay? So kung titingnan natin to, this is a loop type of pattern. And again, itong line na to, si ridge C at saka si ridge 1, ito po yung tinatawag po natin na type lines. Okay? And this area, this is the point of divergence of the two type lines. As you notice po, sa illustration po natin, may dot po tayo dyan. May ridge ending tayo. May bifurcation tayo. May short ridge tayo. May convergence tayo. So yung sinasabi natin kanina, na a delta could either be any of these ridge characteristics po. Now, ang tanong ngayon, saan po dyan ang pipiliin natin na maging delta? For you to be able to know on which among these ridge characteristics that you will choose as a delta, kaya po may tinatawag po tayong rules in the selection of a delta just in case yung sinasabi po nating mga deltas, the ridge characteristics that can be possibly chosen as a delta appears in the point of divergence of the two type lines. Kaya ngayon po, pag-uusapan natin, let us be acquainted with the different rules in the selection of a delta. So punta na tayo ngayon sa rule number one po. Okay? So ano po yung rule number one? Rule number one says, the delta may not be located at a bifurcation which does not open towards the core. I will repeat. A delta may not be located at a bifurcation which does not open towards the core. Okay? So punta tayo sa illustration po. Okay? In this illustration po, this is a loop type of pattern. Taba po ba? And then ipagpalagay po natin that this is the core. Okay? Now, as you notice po, in the point of divergence of these two type lines, ito po yung type lines natin, no? Okay? In this area po, the point of divergence of the two type lines, may dalawang bifurcation po tayo na makikita, di ba? This one and that one. So, lalagyan natin na bifurcation 1 at ito bifurcation number 2. Okay? I hope klaro po dyan, no? So, this is a bifurcation 1, this is a bifurcation 2. I-review lang po natin. Pag sinasabi po natin bifurcation, that is the splitting of one ridge into two or more branches. No? So, the splitting of two ridges. Kung titingnan po natin, this is a one ridge that splits into two or more branches po. Okay? So, as you notice, in this illustration po, may dalawang bifurcation po tayo. Bifurcation number 1 at saka bifurcation number 2. Okay? So, saang bifurcation po ang pipiliin natin na maging delta? Sagot po. Rule number 1 says, a delta may not be located at a bifurcation which does not open towards the core. Dapat nakaharap yung opening niya sa core. Okay? Kung titingnan natin itong bifurcation number 2, the bifurcating ridge ay nakataliko doon sa core natin. Tama ho ba? So dito po siya nakaharap. Okay? Rule number one says, the delta may not be located at the bifurcation which does not open towards the core. Therefore, in this case, ito po ang pipiliin po natin na delta. Okay? So ito na po ngayon yung tinatawag po natin na delta. Bakit ito ang pinipili natin? Because this bifurcation is open towards the core. Yun po ang rule number one. Again, tatandaan natin kung ano po yung rule number one. The delta may not be located at the bifurcation which does not open towards the core. Okay? So ngayon, pupuntahan po natin yung rule number two po. Ano po yung rule number two? Rule number two says, when there is a choice between a bifurcation and another type of delta. Okay? If there is a choice between a bifurcation and another type of delta, the bifurcation must be selected. Ano pong sabi? Kung doon sa point of divergence of the two type lines, marami po kayong pagpipilian na mga delta. Okay? Ang pipiliin nyo raw po must be a bifurcation. So ipagpalagay po natin dito sa illustration natin, no? Considering the fact that this is now yung line na to, yung ridge na to, at saka ito, ito po yung type lines natin because they are the two innermost ridges, no? So this area, dito po mag-a-appear si delta. Now, how if po when at this area, the point of divergence of the two type lines, there gonna be different types of delta or deltas appearing on this side. Okay, pagpalagay natin, andyan si short ridge, andyan si dot, andyan si bifurcation, andyan si converging ridge, andyan si ridge ending, ito. Okay? So how if, in the point of divergence of the two type lines, there gonna be a lot of possible deltas. So saan or ano po ang pipiliin nyo na magiging delta po? Then the answer is very simple. You have to refer that one to rule number two. What is rule number two? When there is a choice between a bifurcation and another type of delta, the bifurcation must be selected. So simple lang po. Okay? So malamang ang pipiliin natin dito si bifurcation. Why? Because number two says, rule number two says, when there is a choice between a bifurcation and another type of delta, the bifurcation must be selected. Okay? So dadako na tayo ngayon sa rule number 3 po natin. So, what is rule number 3? Now, rule number 3 says, when there are a series of bifurcation opening towards the core, the bifurcation nearest to the core must be selected. So, let us say for example, try this one. Okay? Bifurcation number 1. Bifurcation number 2. Bifurcation number 3. Yan. Okay? Bifurcation number 4. Okay? There are 4 bifurcation. Bifurcation number 1. That one. Number 1. That one. Number 2. This one. Number 3. That is bifurcation number 4. There are 4 bifurcations. So, ang tanong ngayon, saan or saan sa apat na bifurcation na to ang pipiliin po nating delta? Then, rule number 3 will answer that question. Diba? Ang sabi ni rule number 3, when there are a series of bifurcation open towards the core, the bifurcation which is nearest to the core must be selected. As you notice po, diba? Si bifurcation number 1. Okay? Si bifurcation number 1 po is the bifurcation which is more nearest to the core. Therefore, out of these 4 bifurcations po, si bifurcation number 1 ang pipiliin po natin na delta. So, sa ngayon, let us proceed to the next rule. Okay? So, the next rule po natin is when there are 2 or more deltas that conforms to the definition, the delta nearest to the core must be selected. Okay? So ano pong sabi? if there are two or more deltas that conforms to the definition, ang pipiliin daw po natin yung delta po na nearest to the core.
So let us illustrate again. Ipagpalagay po natin.
Okay? So this is the point of divergence of the two type lines. Okay, dito may makikita tayong dot, may makikita po tayong short ridge, may makikita po tayong ridge ending. Okay, so tatlo po yung candidate natin na pwede po maging delta. Saan po dito ang pipiliin po natin na delta?
Now, so this is number one, possible delta. Number two, ridge ending is possible delta. Number three,
rule says the delta nearest to the core must be selected. Therefore, in this illustration po, considering the fact, ipagpalagay po natin that this is the core, and then out of these three, the dot is closer to the core. The dot is nearer to the core. Therefore, among these three possible deltas, ang pipiliin po natin si dot. Bakit po? Because the dot is nearer to the core. Okay? So, that is the second to the last rule.
So, dadako na po tayo sa panghuling rule po, no?
So, the last rule says that the delta may not be located in the middle of the ridge running between the two type lines, but at the nearer end only. The delta may not be located at the middle of the ridge running between the two type lines, but at the nearer end only.
So, hindi po pwede na si delta ay makikita in the middle of the ridge.
Dapat si delta ay makikita doon po sa ridge ending. Okay? Because the rule says the delta may not be located at the middle of the ridge running between the two type lines, but at the nearer end only.
So, i-illustrate po natin para klaro po kung ano po ang ibig sabihin sa rule na. See, for example, ito po ang illustration natin. Okay? So again, dito din po yung point of divergence of the two type lines.
No. So dito sana si delta. But again, you cannot put your delta here. Hindi po pwede na nasa middle of the ridge.
So dapat po nasa ridge ending po siya. So ipagpalagay natin again, this is your ridge end number one and this is your ridge end number two.
So ang tanong ngayon, saan po sa dalawang ridge end na to ang pipiliin po natin na delta? Okay? So ngayon ang sagot niyan, kung saan pong ridge end na malapit doon sa point of divergence of the two type lines, siya po ang delta. As you notice po, in this illustration po, mas malapit si ridge ending number 1 compared doon sa ridge end number 2 from here. So, this ridge end is more closer to this point of divergence compared to ridge end number 2. So, in this case, ito po ang pipiliin natin na delta. Simply because this point, this ridge ending po is more closer from the point of divergence of the two type lines. Okay? So, guys, yan po ang ating rules in as far as the selection of E-delta po. So, uulitin ko po, there are 5 rules na pinag-uusapan natin dito. What are those 5 rules? Rule number 1, the delta may not be located at the bifurcation which does not open towards the core. Rule number 2, when there is a choice between a bifurcation and another type of delta, the bifurcation must be selected. Okay? So, rule number 3, when there are a series of bifurcation equally close to the point of divergence and opening towards the core, the bifurcation nearer to the core must be selected. Rule number 4, when there are two or more deltas that conforms to the definition, the delta nearest to the core must be selected. And finally, rule number 5, the delta may not be located at the middle of the ridge running between the two type lines towards the core, but at the nearer end only. Yan po ang mga rules in as far as the selection of a delta is concerned. So guys, naway na paliwanag ko po sa inyo ng maigi yung rules po natin in the selection of a delta po. Okay? So hanggat sa muli po nating pagkikita dito po sa FB or dito po sa YouTube channel po natin. Again, yung hindi pa po nakapag-subscribe sa YouTube channel ko po, please do subscribe and please do not forget to hit or click the notification bell para notified po kayo every time may mga videos po tayo na i-upload sa YouTube po. Okay? So hanggat sa muli, ingat po kayong lahat. Again, this is your coach. This is Coach Ed Montalba. Maraming salamat po.